Coming back again onto the next raw material, that is vinegar. So vinegar should be of a good quality, and they should contain vinegar should contain at least 4% of acetic acid, and vinegar of low acid content or imitation or synthetic vinegars are not suitable for pickling. So the pickles that are of a very, very high standard and that are of a high quality, the vinegar should be of a very good quality and should be of, there are standards of vinegar, 40 to 60 grain, 80 grain strength based on the acetic acid present. Okay, so it should contain, or it must contain 4 to 6% of the acetic acid. So generally cider vinegar or malt vinegars are used. Okay. Some manufacturers also prefer to use directly acetic acid instead of vinegar, and that is also okay because it is highly concentrated and practically it is free from any sediments, any color. So if a fruit vinegar is used, it should be filtered first to remove any sediments that are there. So vinegar should not contain, should not come in contact with iron. Again, I'm repeating it as mentioned before, because it will result into blackening of the pickle. Okay, so that is about vinegar. And the next ingredient is a sugar. So sugar used in the preparation of sweet pickle should be again high quality, without any impurities, without any stones, or any husk or any other material. Spices that are practically used for all pickles again must be of high standard and high quality, and they should not be removed with their, all oleoresins. So the spices generally used are bay leaves, cardamom, cinnamon, clove, coriander, dill herbs, ginger, mace, mustard, black pepper. All you just list out all of the spices that generally used in Indian, context, like mint, sage, parsley, thyme, fennel, aniseed, etc. So all the spices that are being used should be of a good quality and should be stored in a friction top tins in a cool and dry place. The next one is a water. So water, only potable water should be used for preparation of brine, if at all brine preparation is needed. So basically, if the hard water is used, we know that hard water contains, calcium, sodium, magnesium, etc., which will interfere with the normal salt curing, so the curing of the salt in with the salt takes out the water from the vegetable. So if hard water is to be used, a small quantity of vinegar should also be used, so that the brine is neutralized because of its alkalinity. Okay, so iron should not be present into the water in any appreciable quantity, because again it will result into blackening of the pickle. Then a lot of coloring agents are being used in commercial pickle samples. So it is like generally at home when we use, we don't use, once it was the practice to heat the vinegar pickle in the copper vessel to get that, black color or green color. But this is so hazardous, it is very, very hazardous. In fact, it has been now shown that the green color is because of the copper acetate that is formed because of the reaction between the pickle and the vinegar, which is extremely poisonous compound. And the use of this copper vessel for making pickle therefore has been banned or prohibited, okay, at least in many countries. But in India still there are some people who use. So colors are not generally added to pickle, although there are some that could be used, like in sauces, though very commonly they are used. So some manufacturers use alum for firmness in pickle also, but it is not commonly used as a hardening agent. But yes, the use of alum in pickup packing is therefore not recommended as a normal practice. So color is not, but in India, I have seen in some houses, the turmeric is added, which is a natural ingredient also, taste enhancer also, okay. So before we move into pickling process, quickly I want to tell you in the commercial scale or in the commercial operation, what are the equipments that are used. So I am not sure if you have visited any industries, but in Pune there are so many pickle industries, and the most famous one in Praveen and a few others. I have visited those pickle industries and I have seen how, you know, the process of the pickle making commercially, they do. So therefore I am just explaining it. So basically wide mouthed stone jars with the straight sides are highly suitable for making the small quantity of pickle. So what is the advantage of this use of this container? So the advantage of such containers are that they can be easily cleaned and they absorb any undesirable flavors and odors to a less extent than the wooden containers. I am not sure how many of you are aware, but in the village and during my childhood, I have seen, like, literally, you know, people use earthen pots which has those holes, and they use that particular container for, you know, several years and years, because, you know, the earthen pots, the lactic acid bacteria remains there even if this year's stock of pickles gets over. And then, you know, these lactic acid bacteria will cause further fermentation in the next stock, even if you wash and clean them, okay. And that gives a very typical fermented phase. So for large scale production, around 227 or a bigger capacity of kegs or barrels are suitable. So the one that I visited, I have seen, you know, they were like made from plastic. So before use, the barrels are washed, they are thoroughly, you know, cleaned. And if they are, you know, using certain other material, so the chemicals are also used for properly washing to remove any undesirable flavors or odor. Also, you know, so these kegs are then thoroughly washed with the hot water. And then the covers of the kegs are also, you know, generally they are very thick and they should be made up of material that would not again impart any color, taste, flavor of its own to the pickle. And the kegs, the covers should be of 2.5 to 5 centimeter in diameter than inside of the container. Why? Because there is this gap is kept so that they can be easily placed inside the keg on the top of the vegetable, and they can be later on removed also when desired. Okay, so they should be coated with the paraffin wax to fill up any pores in them to facilitate the cleaning of that. So generally what machineries or equipments are used? So weighing scales are most needed. It's not a very big, you know, industry wherein you need a very huge equipment or very huge, you know, sophisticated equipment or investment. So just a weighing scale, a large scale essential if the production is really big. Liquid measurement units like water, brine, other liquids can be measured conveniently or weighed. So 0.5 liter, 1 liter, 2 liter, 4 liter measurements are suitable. You need also cooking utensils, as I mentioned. Non-corrodible metallic vessels are not recommended. So also iron, copper are not used. But glass-lined vessels made up of stainless steel could be used, okay. And in some of the industries, aluminium can also be used. The ladles, spoons, and measuring vessels should also be non-corrodible, okay. And then once you have the sufficient basic equipments, the process of pickling starts. So in pickling, generally is done into two stages. Number one is curing or fermentation with the dry salting or fermentation in brine, or salting without fermentation. And the second one is finishing and packing. Okay. Now let us understand what is dry salting. So in this method, the vegetables are treated with the dry salt, as the name indicates, dry salting. The salt in this process extracts the juice from the vegetable and it forms the brine, which is fermented by lactic acid bacteria. And this method of dry salting in general is carried out as follows. So basically the vegetables are prepared, like they are prepared means like a mango. So they are cut, okay, into the specific size, like prepared, like removed with the core, dirty or spoiled mango, ripened mangoes. So they are washed thoroughly in the running cold water. They are drained and weighed. And for every 100 kg of the prepared vegetable, around 3 kg of the salt is used. So this variety or this recipe will vary from the fruit to fruit. Either it could be any recipe, depend on the what vegetable is used. So the vegetable is generally placed about 2.5 centimeter deep in the keg or barrel, okay, and is sprinkled with a small quantity of salt from the weighed amount, okay, of the salt. And another layer of the vegetable is added, and then again sprinkled with the salt. Then again the salt is added, and layer by layer in this manner till the keg is 3/4. Like suppose, you know, this is the keg. In this keg you put salt, vegetable, salt, vegetable, likewise, okay, layer by layer. In this manner till the keg is 3/4 full, then 1 or 2 fold of cheesecloths or muslin cloths are spread over the salted vegetable and tucking the cloth. So the cloth is tucked at the side and then placing a wooden board onto the top of it. Okay. Or sometimes, you know, the clean stone, which is not acted upon by salt or organic acid, is also placed on the board. So objective of putting here, you know, heavy material or a heavy weight is because of we know that if we want it, the heavy weight to cause the pressing. Okay. So when this stone, heavy stone, will cause the pressing of the vegetable so as to form a brine. So generally a stone weight of around 4 to 5 kg will be sufficient in case of 22 liter of cake. If necessary, additional weight may be also placed in case the brine doesn't form after the material has stood for some time. So generally brine is formed in about 24 hours. So after the packing the vegetable, the keg is placed in a warm and dry place and fermentation is allowed to proceed. So in a short period of time, and we know that the salt and the vegetable that has a water content, that will result into osmosis. The due to this osmosis, juice from the vegetable will come out and that will form the brine, and that brine will cover the whole mass, and the weighted board, this helps in keeping the vegetable submerged in the brine. If there would not have been this weight, this would not have been happened. Okay. So it enhances, it catalyzes. As soon as the brine is formed, what will the next procedure? Fermentation will start, and the bubbles of the carbon dioxide begin to rise from the liquid. So fermentation is usually completed in around 8 to 10 days. Of course, the temperature is important. What temperature you are allowing it to carry out, okay? So under favorable condition, but most commonly a temperature of 27 to 32 degrees Celsius is most commonly used. So in cold weather, it will take around, you know, 4 to 5 weeks. But during the summer, it will be very, very quick. And when the fermentation is over, the gas bubble ceases and they ceases to form and they rise, and this may be confirmed by tapping the keg gently. So here the product may now be preserved and kept by excluding the air. And if what will happen if you do not remove the air? The pickles come, which is a kind of wild yeast that will appear onto the surface immediately, you know. So it should destroy the lactic acid formed by fermentation, which will result into the spoilage of the pickle. Okay. So according to one of the scientists, air can be exhausted or expelled into using various ways. So method one, in this method, after dry salting and fermentation, the barrels or the keg, which are filled with the vegetable pickle to its maximum capacity, and the cover is replaced. So a 1.25 centimeter hole is bored into the head, and then the barrel is filled to the brim with the brine so that a very little air is left inside. And these barrels are allowed to stand for about 48 hours till such time that the bubbles or gas cease to rise. In another case, if there is a necessity, more brine can also be added in between the intervals to keep the barrel full. And when the bubbling has stopped, the vent hole is closed tightly and the barrel is kept in a cool and dry place. And then the product that is packed in this manner will keep for a very, very long period of time. In the second method, generally paraffin wax, which is a hot and molten, is used to cover the surface of the brine. So in this case, the barrel is kept in a place where it will not be disturbed until the material is ready for use. So sufficient paraffin wax is melted and poured over the surface of the brine. So in case if it is not enough to warm up the surface of the brine, generally a smooth and even layer of it will be formed and before it cools and hardens, and this will give an airtight seal. So basically, what are the advantages of using the paraffin wax? Number one advantage, it can be easily separated from the fermented brine before you remove the vegetable from the barrel. And number two, it can be remelted, it can be refined, and it can be used again. So it is a very cost effective. The only disadvantage, however, is in case any gas is produced in the brine after scaling this wax, it will rise up and it will break the seal, and resealing will be very, very necessary. Okay. So the wax seal should not therefore be applied before fermentation. Okay. So if I ask you the question, why the waxing is not allowed to before fermentation, this should be the reason. Okay. Because if it is not complete, the gas formation, until the gas formation has ceased. Okay. So fermentation in brine, sometimes, you know, steeping of the vegetable in the salt solution or of predetermined. Yeah, there is an almost one more step, but yeah. So sometimes, you know, there is one more method here for preservation, is fermentation in brine. So basically, you know, steeping of the vegetable in the salt solution of a predetermined concentration for a certain period of time is called as the brining. So this type of treatment is adopted in case of cucumbers and other vegetables which do not contain sufficient amount of juice to form brine with the dry salt. So brine preparation, how it is done? Basically, brine can be prepared simply by dissolving the salt in a water, and you filter it so that if there is any impurity, the salt will get removed, like insoluble impurity. The amount of brine that is necessary to cover vegetable is generally equal to about half of the volume of the material that is needs to be fermented. Like if you have 1 kg, so it should be around 50%, okay, 500 gram, okay. So to be more precise, if a keg of a 45.4 liter capacity is to be packed, an amount of brine required would be around 22.7 or 23 liters. Okay, so it is preferable that you make the whole quantity of brine that is needed for the day in a one lot. Okay, so brining is one of the most important step in pickling. Although no set of conditions ordinarily practicable in pickle making will destroy or it will retard the growth of every kind of bacteria, but the growth of majority of them is checked in brine containing around 15% salt. Okay, so basically lactic acid bacteria which are salt tolerant can then flourish in a brine of 8 to 10% length only, strength only. So fermentation will take place in a brine containing solution of a 5% salt. In a brine containing approximately 10% salt, fermentation process becomes little bit slow. We know that as the salt concentration is high, the fermentation will decrease. To some extent, fermentation takes place up to 15%. But beyond that, like 20% strength, the fermentation stops. So therefore, customary to place the vegetable in 10% salt. Generally, with the brines are recommended, so 10% salt solution is allowed to add, and this will allow the growth of lactic acid fermentation to take place, and then to increase the proportion of salt gradually. Like you add little salt, you allow the fermentation to take place, and then gradually you can add more salt, so that by the time the pickle is ready, salt concentration would have reached around 15% level, and it is to be then kept in mind that the vegetable contain a certain amount of moisture which exudes from them in the presence of salt, and this water that exudes out from the vegetable lowers the strength of brine. Okay, and the brine strength can however be maintained by adding again externally. You can add salt, but of course you have to keep it in mind that what is the taste of that salt. So generally keeping quality of this properly brined vegetable will keep well in a vinegar for a very very long period of time, and the duration of brining is of course very very important. If the vegetable are soaked for a short time of about only 12 hours, the curing of the vegetable tissue will be incomplete, with the result that the pickle will not have a proper texture and taste. Okay, it will be like mushy, it will not be like crunchy. So brining has a very very important role. Okay, so it needs to be controlled properly. So on curing the vegetable, they become semi translucent, and also the color changes from a green to a olive green color. I am sure you must have seen, or sometimes even if you don't use turmeric, it becomes yellowish green. So this is nothing but, this is an indication of correct curing. It is called as a curing of vegetable. And this usually happens naturally in a week of around 4 to 5 weeks at a temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. So by this method, the vegetable can be kept even more or less for an indefinite period, provided the condition, the right storage conditions are maintained. So if the vegetables are kept in a brine of a 10% or less, and all air is excluded from the container during the curing of the vegetable, you know, that will result really into a longer period. Okay, in the salt also, the generally a very good shelf life can be obtained, and also, you know, in the presence of vinegar. So there are variety of causes of spoilage. The recipes of the pickles I will be sharing in the food processing laboratory. Okay, so there are various causes of spoilage, and number one is shriveling. Shriveling occurs when the vegetable like cucumber are placed directly, if you put them in a very very strong salt or a very very strong sugar, and even in a very strong vinegar. Okay, so to avoid this, generally weak solution should be used to start with, and then slowly the concentration of the strength or the concentration of the strength of the concentration will be gradually increased. Bitter taste. So generally the bitter taste to the pickle is because of the use of strong vinegar again, and it can also be caused by cooking the spices for a long time, and also it is called as because of over spicing. Blackening, as I mentioned before, it is because of the iron which enters through the brine or from the equipment, and sometimes also there are certain bad bacteria which will cause the blackening. Dull and faded products. Pickles becomes dull and faded due to insufficient curing or use of materials of inferior quality. Then softness and slipperiness is also seen, and this is because of the action of bacteria and is the most common form of spoilage, and it is because of the inadequate covering with the brine, or it is because of the use of weak brine, or by using a brine of proper strength and by keeping the pickle well below the surface of the brine, and this kind of spoilage can be eliminated. Scum formation, as I mentioned you before, this is a kind of a mold. So when vegetables are placed in a brine for curing, a white scum is formed onto the surface owing to the growth of wild yeast, and this scum may be either thin or thick in appearance. This will vary from an almost perceptible film to a very, very thick wrinkled layer. And this restarts the formation of lactic acid bacteria, and as this action may also help the growth of putrefactive bad bacteria, which causes the vegetable to become soft, to become slippery. Therefore, it is very, very important the moment this scum is formed, you remove this scum as soon as it is formed. Addition of about 1% of acetic acid helps in prevention of growth of these wild yeast onto the brine, and without in any of the way hindering the formation of lactic acid. And for this reason, in some of the commercial pickles, a small amount of vinegar to the brine in the initial step itself is added. Okay. So cloudiness again is very common. When vegetables are placed in vinegar, it is generally presumed that the products will not spoil, because we know that the salt, vinegar, everything. But in case of onion and some other vegetable, sometimes vinegar becomes cloudy and turbid, and then spoiling the appearance of the pack. So these raw material being of a very solid structure, like this onion and some vegetable, they have a very, very solid structure. The acetic acid in the vinegar may not be able to penetrate deep into these tissues of the onion, and they prevent the activity of bacteria or other microorganism that may be present in them, which will result their fermentation starts from inside, okay, rendering the vinegar cloudy. So this activity of microorganism can be only checked by proper brining. So cloudiness may also be because of the use of a vinegar which is of a inferior quality, or there are imitation vinegar. Possibly it could be because of the chemical action between vinegar and the impurities such as calcium, magnesium, iron coming from the impure quality or inferior quality of salt. So salt that is used is also very, very important. Or it could be because of the action between the minerals and vinegar. So minerals that are present naturally in some of the vegetable. Okay. So there are sometimes, you know, the defects like blemishes in pickled onions are also seen. So blemishes means blemishes may sometimes occur in the pickle, especially in onion pickles in vinegar, and you will see, you know, white blotch is sometimes seen under the first layer of the skin, and this is because of, you know, some kind of fermentation, and also if the curing and brining is not proper. So next, let us understand what are the variety of pickles that could be made. So there are several kind of pickles sold in the Indian market, like mango pickle ranks the first. Then comes cauliflower, turnip pickles, followed by lime, chili, bamboo, etc. So pickles are basically classified according to the method of their preparation. So vinegar pickles are the most important one in other countries. And there are sour, sweet, spiced, and mustard pickles. Picked onions, pickled onions occupy a very, very prominent place among the pickles imported into this country. Then comes the mixed pickle. Then there are others. Okay.